Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope whatever we discussed about home science and whatever the introduction I gave you about home science and about the definition of home science, I hope it's clear to you all. And in case any problem, feel free to send your questions on the group, okay? Today we'll seeing what is concept of home science. We'll see what is the concept of home science, and basically in the concept of home science there are two types of concepts, that is traditional concept and modern concept. So we'll see what is the concept. The concept of home science can be viewed through traditional concept and modern concept, and we'll see what is traditional concept. In the traditional concept, home science as a discipline centers around home and family. Its inception in the early part of 20th century. So the inception of home science came into existence in the earlier part of 20th century. And as you know, it's like a discipline centers. And these centers are where? Around the home and around the family. It was originally conceptualized as an interdisciplinary applied science, drawing upon the knowledge from physical, biological and social sciences. It was originally conceptualized to an interdisciplinary applied science. It is said that home science is like an applied science. Why it is applied science? Because in this we apply things for us in the home, in the family, in the household. Everything, we can apply things to us. That's why it is said that it is applied science, drawing upon the knowledge from physical needs, biological needs and social sciences. All many types of whatever sciences are available, this home science is interrelated to all these sciences. All these sciences, chemistry, biology, physics, everything is related to all these things. That's why it is said that it is interrelated. Because it enhances family welfare, because it is all related with welfare of the family. It is a field which emerges out of the need for training girls in the context of changes in the socio-economic environment. It is a field which emerges out of the need. What the need that emerged out was the that it was the training given to girls in the context of changes in the socio-economic environment. When things started changing up, changes was seen in the socio-economic environment. So it was a training for the girls so that they'll know what are the changes going to come in the family, in the socio-economic environment, as well as in the system of the family and about in the functions of the family. Children, when we stay in a family, maybe you may not be knowing about the different things which are there in the family. Suppose physical needs, emotional needs and biological needs, social needs, so many things are there. And who is the coordinator of the family? Mainly the mother, who deals with everything so nicely, because she has the capacity of doing these things. And when you are home science, you are aware of all these things. And when you are aware about these things, you will be able to do it in a more better way. Then the modern concept. It is only recently that the importance of home science has been recognized. So very lately, the home science has came into existence. Very lately, people came to know about home science. In its modern concept, home science is the systematic arrangement, both material and physical. It's an arrangement which is being done systematically, both materially as well as physically, for running individual homes. Suppose a homemaker, who is the homemaker? Mothers are the homemaker, and they run the home so efficiently, so nicely, that people may not be knowing what problems she is facing. But while running the home, lot many problems come, which would ultimately result in peace, prosperity and progress of human community. And when the home will develop nicely in given proper guidance, given proper environment, then what will happen? It will become a perfect family in the human community, in the society where we are staying. The scope is very wide and the implications are very deep. The scope of home science, when you will study home science later on, you will come to know that there are immense opportunities, many variety of scope you will there, you will see, and the implications are very deep, and the importance of it is also very, very deep. It gives you a deep knowledge about each specialization. Home science has now become a mission oriented field, with not only the goals of enabling families to be more self-sufficient. So home science has become very mission oriented. It has got a wide mission to be completed. That's why it is called mission oriented field, with not only the goals of enabling families to be more self-sufficient, it helps the families to be more self-efficient, do everything very efficiently, very nicely, and developing the full potential of all individuals. But and it, this way, when the family is self-sufficiently doing the works very nicely, what happens? The full potential of all individuals, but also with the profession of the community development. When we are fully equipped with all the things, I'm sure you help out the other people also who are not well equipped. Suppose someone is coming to help you out as a helper in the family, and suppose that person wants to study, I'm sure people are there to help them out. They make them learn the basic things, they give the basic knowledge of Hindi and English, like alphabets, and also that the person may be able to write name. So this way, what happens? When we are helping others also, we are helping ourselves as well as the other people also, in the way uplifting the community. It motivates the community for better living. And when you help the community, you are helping them in their uplifting their life for a better living. Home science, more than other science, has become a discipline dealing with people and community. So home science is a science. It is basically deals with the people as well as the community where we are staying, in its natural setup for betterment of their own life. In whatever the setup is present there, we in that natural setup only, we help the people staying close by for the betterment of their life, so that they may also be well equipped with the knowledge, and they may also be become career oriented. Okay. Then about the five streams of home science. I told you about the five streams. The home science is basically divided into five streams, very important five streams, and we'll study it about it. Home science education paves the way to help, understand, and act through multi-sectoral approaches. So there are multi-sectoral approaches. When you talk about home science, there are multi-sciences are related to it. So these multi-sectoral approaches help the people in a way to have a knowledge for helping others and to understanding the people around us. The basic sectors such as food, clothing, shelter, healthcare, and psychology. The basic sector which deals with home science is what? Food, clothing, shelter, healthcare, psychology, human relations, and development of human values. Human relations, how well we are having the human relations in the family, and how well we are helping others to make it in a better way. And development of human values, what the values are, ethics are there, how much it is important we are giving it to a proper weight for its proper importance or not, and social needs and human socio-culture linkage, and whatever needs we have, how well we are trying to make out the needs of other people, and having socio-culture linkages, what culture we have and how well we are going to enhance the culture of other people, and helping them in their culture upliftment also. From the basic areas of home science facilitates the integration of these basic and related areas and synthesizes the best in family living. So home science helps in the all the basic related areas, and how well we are able to synthesize it well with the living also, with our family living also. We try to interrelate to it so that the basic areas, interdisciplinary subjects, they may all help people in the better upliftment of the family and its living. Okay, so here this diagram you can see that home science, it has food and nutrition, human development, resource management, clothing and textile, communication and extension. These are the five branches which deals with home science, and one by one we'll see what is this. Food and nutrition. Food and nutrition deals with the relationship between man and his food. You know, food is one of the most important basic needs, because without food it's very difficult to live. So food is one of the main important need of our life. The food and nutrition which deals with the study of the following aspect. So what are the following aspect? Constituents of food. Whatever constituents, whatever nutrition is present in the food, we try to know that. And when we will know that these constituents, these nutrients are present in this food, when we'll come to know about it, then only it will be a help for us so that we'll eat nicely. Suppose we know that in spinach, you know what is spinach? Palak. Palak is a very good source of iron. So when we know that it has a very good source of iron, we'll have palak very often. But people who don't know, if they don't like the taste of palak, they will not eat unknowingly, because they don't know that it has a very good quality of having good source of iron. Then functions of food. There's a wide variety of functions of food, and we'll see it what are the main functions. Biological, physiological, social and economic factors that govern the choice of food for one's own nourishment. And for our own nourishment, of our body. Nourishment means how well we are taking things which will help our body to develop nicely. So these are physical, psychological, social and economic factors help in the development of a body. Then personal, family and community needs of food. Food, what we are eating, whether it is helpful to us, whether it is giving a proper nutrition to our body or not, we have to know it. Then only it's good that we studied home science, and now we'll know what we are eating, and we can help these things to know the other people also. The people who are living, suppose close by villages, they don't know about this nourishment part, and see our duty to help them out, know that eat this, and from this you'll get proper nourishment. Planning, preparing and serving of nutritious food. When we are preparing something, first we have to plan it, then we have to prepare it, and then we can serve it nicely. Suppose we planned something to make very nicely, and then we prepared also, but as far as the serving part is concerned, suppose it is not served properly, the color part is not very, very appealing, not very encouraging, you don't feel like eating it. But you have to see that these three main parts are very important, that how well we have planned it and how well we have prepared it, and at the same time the serving part, the how well we have served it in a proper way. Food habits and practices. What are food habits? In the habits you'll see whether we are having a breakfast at proper time or not, lunch at proper time, dinner at proper line, proper time. And practices, what practices we are, whether we having junk food or good food, we must know about it. Table manners and services. We must know what are the table manners, how well we have to sit on the table, how well we have to use the fork and spoon, everything. Food production, conservation and preservation. how well we the food is food is being protecting conservation and preservation. Jo about food we must have knowledge, how well it has been done in the production part, how well it has been done in the conservation part, and then about the preservation. When we study about preservation, I'll tell you in detail what is preservation. Food for special occasions. You know that in a family, when there's special occasion, there's a special food. Suppose festivals, birthday parties, or whatever, get-togethers. There's special food for special occasion. Food for special categories of individuals such as infants, preschool children, school-going children, adolescents, old, pregnant, and lactating women. There is food. Special categories of individuals. Suppose infant is there, small child is there, everybody is having different type of food. School going child will have a different breakfast than the infant. Then adolescents, elder brothers and sisters, they have different types of food when they go to college and all. Old and pregnant and lactating women. Pregnant ladies, they have a different type of food. And lactating mothers who feed their children, they have different type of food. Knowledge about different types of methods of cooking with their advantages and disadvantages. We have to know about the different methods of food, how well we are cooking the food nicely, so that whatever nutrition is present in that, we are having that. It's not going to destroy it. While cooking it, we must know about all this. Handling of kitchen equipments, how well we are handling the equipments present in the kitchen nicely. Food hygiene and food hazards, what hygiene should follow while preparing the food in the kitchen, and what are the hazards which we should be careful while preparing food. Catering is different institutions and hotel, how well we have to cater it, how well we are catering the food. Suppose in any institutions or hotels, we must know about it. And large scale cooking, and how well we are cooking for the people. If they are, suppose there's a big group for your party or for your get together, how well you will be able to manage. So you see that food and nutrition caters all these points very nicely in a very wide specialized way. So I think this much of little idea about food and nutrition is more than enough for you. Tomorrow I'll see human development. You can also call it human development. That is the second part. Human development is also called child development and family studies. So we'll see about it tomorrow. Please go through the whatever I discussed it, go through it. And in case any problem, please come to it. Okay? Thank you.